Right, is it on? Yeah, it's on. Welcome back, everybody. On this episode, I thought I'll do something a little bit different. I'll get out of the water and I'll stay on the dry land. I'll show you a bit of what I do for a professional living. Camera trapping, letting you see the unseen in the forest, unless, of course, if you're a hunter. All right? So we had about 4 traps out in the field for a short while now, but we go back and we check on it to make sure nobody tampered with it, no branches came down and obstructed the view, making sure that everything is running. Problem is, when you don't take GPS units of where you put them, you have to be able to find them back somehow or the other, right? No. I know it around here somewhere, but I'll find it eventually. What I'm hoping is that I find the camera traps before I find a mapapi or a big tarantula or something. Those are things that have me uneasy out in the field. I don't like it, but gotta find it.
Listen, if them bees taking you, run, eh? Wait for me.
So if it look like we're walking around in circles and we don't know what we're doing, you're halfway right. We are walking around in circles, but we do know what we're doing. We're gonna find it. Now, if you're a man of the bush, you would just say, why you don't follow the chop marks or the trail marks that, you know, led me into here in the first place. But that is something that I don't do. I don't like to mark the areas that I'm going in because I don't want to rouse any suspicion from anybody who in the bush, you know, they see something look like an opening or a trail or a man pass there, they want to pass through, they want to see where it have. No, I don't do that because I've lost equipment in the past. So, this is me finding it still. Little relieved that I found the camera trap, and this is what the camera trap would be looking at. This is the view.
Careful, it have any little ants, wasps, centipede, caterpillars inside
also
there.
Also scorpions and spiders.
Last week, when we picked up, we had an ocelot crossing right there. We were first drawn to this spot because we see plenty of tattoo digging up. But I think we get agouti and plenty plowy or Trinidad spiny rats in this zone. Laptop in the jungle. We hope it don't rain. So some of the cool stuff we got here, I'm just gonna go through fast and you'd see the animals that we picked up. So that's an ocelot, maniku, Trinidad spiny rat. Spiny rat all over the place, yeah. Then we're supposed to have a goatee in the back. Hey, look him there, man. That's it.
We service the trap, we make sure everything running fine, we download whatever images it had, and we reset it up again for the next fortnight to come. If you're fine, you didn't get to see the animals, don't worry. I'm going to show you a lot at the end of the video. So again, I'm walking away from my camera trap, my valuable piece of equipment. And I'm trying not to like break branches or create a track or any disturbance that will bring any attention to the area.
My puppies, they are here. Ooh, seen some. When you're walking in the bush without a blade, you have to be very careful about where you pass. You don't want to get stuck by wait a while. So just carefully. Ah, shit. See the same thing I'm talking about? You just go around it. Take the long way out. And avoid it. I swear, like I just seen more and more. I know this is not where we passed. Huh? Out here too. I'm just trying to show some of the footage here now. Love to see big vines in the forest.
Big vines, and plenty big vines, are an indicator that a piece of forest is or has been left undisturbed for a long piece of time.
As we call a wild chatine. This is not something you want to put your hands on if you're falling. Going all the way up to the top, I believe that's a wild piwa. See the palm front for it right there. Alright, so we reach our next little spot. You'll notice as the area here a little bit clear as opposed to in the background there. That's because we just, you know, clear the ground of anything that will obstruct the view and more importantly give us false triggers. There's a poor sight. Only Manicou pass here. Nothing of interest so far. What's that? Remember the yellow jap?
Yeah.
Well, if you see me running, pal, you know why. Just don't shake no branch.
Yeah, but remember, I can still be on here.
Plenty flies here, boy. Good shit down there. Wait, look at this big branch fall along in front of the camera trap. Come through.
All was going well, except with this last one here, the memory card didn't want to stay locked inside the camera.
So, modern times call for modern solutions. The SD card not locking, but good old toothpick. Of course, if the SD card not locking, it's not going to read, right? Boom. Put it on. And we in the game.
It just needed a little MacGyvering. If you don't know what MacGyvering is, you're not a child of the 80s. But seriously, if you don't know what or who MacGyver is, go check it out. That man could fix anything with two burn matchsticks and a Swiss pocket army knife. Yep, that's your man, Richard Dean Anderson, aka MacGyver.
Could run into a problem there to...
Like cutting it too short, huh?
To pull it back out there.
You gotta get a tweezer.
Well, I could probably use the same thing and just grab it and pull, but I have a tweezer. Yeah, you can shut him
so
off.
So that was it. We made it to the end of our rounds. We check everybody, we download everybody, we fix everybody. And for you, making it this far into the video, I'm going to give you a treat of a collage of pictures and videos of various animals that I picked up all over the place doing camera trap work for the last 6 years.
In the jungle, the mighty jungle, the
I really hope you enjoy that. There are so much more animals that I find on the camera traps than I could have shown. Give me your feedback. Let me know if you want to see more animals. Let me know if you know everything that you saw. More importantly, if you're a man in the woods, a hunter, somebody that doing gardening or whatever, I would love to link up and do something with you.